This is the Gaumont British News, presenting the world to the world. One of the few flags of freedom in Europe flew above Britain's ambassador to Ankara, Sir Hugh Nashbull Hugesson, who was followed by the ambassador from Tokyo, who in turn was followed by one of the chief Nazi troublemakers, von Papen from Berlin. The Soviet ambassador also attended, and finally the president of the Turkish Republic, President Inuinu. It was the 18th anniversary of the foundation of the Republic, and it finds Turkey a lonely lighthouse in a sea strewn with the nations wrecked by Germany. But Turkey today is united. Her unity is a legacy from the wise government of her great soldier statesman Kemal Atatürk. There was a modern touch in the display of paratroops, watched by the British naval attaché Captain O'Donnell, who sat not far from von Papen, diplomatic necessity, not choice. Turkish troops wore British steel helmets as they marched in the parade, and our pictures followed the American promise to supply Turkey with war requirements under lease lend. Turkey badly needs military equipment. It is important that it should be supplied in case Hitler should demand right of way for his troops. Apart from that, a British victory in the Middle East would constitute an enormous strengthening of Turkey's position.